Welcome, Supremos, to the land of Alvin Lee, 10 years after an woodchopper's ball. And it's the land of the hammer and the pull-off. And Alvin used to play this stuff on a guitar, looking something like this, big red in his case, Gibson Red 335. And his whole style was really a jazz style. And he didn't really, for me, improvise as such. The solos tended to be kind of rows of riffs. Now we'll go into riffs in another chapter of this saga. A riff is basically a repetitive series of notes, a motif it would have been called, or is called in classical music. So when you sort of analyse his playing, each kind of chorus of solo, each verse tends to be a riff. And the riff I'm going to show you is from this number Woodchopper's Ball. Please buy the album Undead and buy it. Don't sort of illegally download it. It is, for my money, the best live guitar album ever made. It's got its humour in it. Alvin is typically monosyllabic, but the track Woodchopper's Ball, to make sense of it at all, you need to play it at half speed, and even then it's a challenge deciphering some of it. But I'm going to take just one bit of it, and the purpose of this is not the, oh, let's teach you how to play Woodchopper's Ball. You know, I'm not into that, though. I enjoy practicing the licks from the number. This is really to show you about when hammers and pull-offs are played on the beat. I must admit, in my own playing, I'm inclined to use them to play sort of behind and ahead of the beat. But Alvin, like a good jazz player, plays them on the beat. And the lines I'm going to teach you slowed down sound like this. Now, sometimes it's easy to play them faster than slower, but the whole thing in this is in the hand coordination, which is why I picked this one. And that's why I practice with this one, because it's difficult for anyone who's not Alvin Lee to play like this, and it's certainly really good discipline for getting coordination into your hand. So that first phrase, now that is an amazing line, and you wouldn't get away with it played slow. See, what's going on there, when it's played fast, it gives the illusion of being picked, but it's not. In fact, you've got, listen. Da-da-dee-dee. There are four notes from one pick there. It's amazing. And the next bit is down to the second string, which is just a pull from 7 to 5. In fact, just to let you know, the original is in C, but I've taken it down to A to stay true to our lesson so far. Sounds better in C. A bit tenser, but I'm playing it in A, because I'm good like that, you know? So that's repeated, so it's done twice. And now this is when it gets trickier. It goes, so that's a rundown on the first string, on the second string, and on the third string. And the easy thing is, all of those runs are identical. And then it ends up back in the house box, 7th fret on the 4th and 5th strings. And then, that's on the 3rd string from the 5th fret, the flatted 3rd to the natural. we're on the second string now. And then the last time. This is a really tricky phrase here. So it's gone from the pull from on the second string from the 8th to the 7th fret. But then it goes down to the 3rd string, 5th fret. Doing the usual minor 3rd up to major 3rd. So it's... And to end it off, so right from the top, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hardly a bend in sight, sorry, just getting a bit carried away there. So if you can practice that, just starting it slowly each time. To say, I hope it's obvious from the way I'm playing, you have to use the fourth finger on this to play these. When you're playing the Dancing Girls thing, because we're using the ninth and the sixth in this, you can't get away any longer with using your third finger for the legs. You have to use the fourth finger, which technically, I guess on the guitar, if I were a proper guitarist, I would do all the time, but you'd never be able to do bends like that with the fourth finger, so. And if you're not used to using the fourth finger, the little finger, the pinky, you probably find this challenging, but it'll be good for strengthening your fingers. And at some point, you have to get used to using that fourth finger. When we start getting into some sort of cooler, more sophisticated jazz-related stuff, and some proper scales, then four fingers imperative. So it's not too early to start learning to use it now. But hey, we're not going to make a case study out of Woodchopper's Ball for the next 6 months. I just want you to get used to playing that little exercise, that little chorus. You've got a full chorus of Woodchopper's Ball there, just to get used to playing hammers and pull-offs. So one more time. Oh, and don't say, oh, that's too complicated for me, because it ain't. You know all of the notes there now. You should know what they are by now, and you should know why they're being played. So we've got the legs, we've got the minor third, the flattened seventh, minor seventh, we've got the sixth and the ninth, And we've got the flattened third to natural third in there as well. There is nothing... Oh, we've even got a flattened fifth in there as well. So there is nothing there you don't already know. So if anyone's turning around saying, I don't understand this, then sorry, but you do now. And this is the whole point of this lesson and the whole point of this learning for life. I'm trying to get you to think independently now. So now we're starting to do a bit of analysis. You realise, actually, I already know this stuff. So then it might be hard to play, and believe me, it's blooming hard to decipher it from the record in this particular case. You should know those notes, and you should know a little bit about why they're being played, about this duality of major and minor, and what's going on here. But these are riffs as well, and we'll talk a bit more about riffs another time. You can have fun with riffs, and certainly riffs come originally from jazz music, and I guess from classical music in reality, but used a lot in blues and latterly in rock. Been rather poorly used in later forms of rock, I think, but that's where the riff is used a lot, and used a lot in blues, so we'll be doing more on that. Anyway, get on with Woodchopper's Ball, get those fingers sparkling, and I will look forward to seeing you again soon. Cheers.